A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
As you all know, you will be learning something new today. But before doing that, let us revise what we learned in the last class. Can you tell why we use the count formula? With count, you can count the number of cells that have some numbers in them. Can you tell why is count blank used? Using count blank, you can get a count of all the blank cells in the data or table that you select. Why do we use the count A formula? Count A formula helps you to count all the cells that have numbers or text in them. Can you tell what is the difference between average and average A? With the average formula, you can derive the average of any group of numbers, whether it has text or numbers. The average formula does not count the text. However, average A formula, along with the numbers, considers each text value as 1 and as such gives the average after combining both the text and numbers. Can you tell why the square root or the SQRT formula is used? SQRT will help you to get the square root value of any number. For example, if you give the number as 49, SQRT will give you its square root value as 7. All of you now switch on your computers and open the Calc file using the method taught to you. Let's now see what you are going to learn today. In today's class, you will make a table and then you will learn about some of the options of the data menu like define range, select range, sorting, filter, subtotal, validation, and text to column. Then you will learn about the formulas for now, today, month, day, and year. Lastly, you will practice some of the formulas done in the previous class. Go ahead and make the table being shown to you or open an existing saved Calc file. Have you all made the table? We will now learn about define range and select range option of the data menu. Using define range, you can select any part of the table which you need to use repeatedly. And if you want to view the data that you have defined, you will use the select range option. Watch the video to learn more about define range and select range. With the help of this video, we are going to see how we can use define range and select range options. So with define range, we can select any row, column or the whole table and define it, because we are going to be using it many times. So for instance, here in the video, we have selected the A column. Then we go take a pointer to data and click on define range. A box opens. You can now name this column by any name that you want to define it. So we are naming it as name. We click on add and it comes in the box below, and then we click on OK. So our first column, A column, has been defined as name. We select the next column, the B column, take a pointer to data, click on define range. This time we are going to call it class. So the B column is called class. We click on add and then we click on OK. So you can see it has come in the box below. Similarly, let's select the C column and take a pointer to data menu, click there, left click there, click on the define range. This time let's put the name as present. And again we will go to add button, click on that and then click on OK, and you see that it comes in the box below. Similarly, let's do this for the D column, which is for the leaves. So we select that, go to data, go to define range, select define range. When the box opens, type the name here for this column. So let's type the name as leaf. Click on add, click on OK. So this way we are defining all the columns, we are giving them some names. So we select that, go to data, go to define range. So this last column we are defining as total. Again, go to add and then click on OK so that you can see it in the box below. So if you want to reuse these columns again and again, you don't have to select them. You just select range from the data and you can open or select the one which you have defined already. We can do one more define. We can select the whole table and let's go to data. Let's call it all, A-L-L, all. So this way we have now defined all the columns. We have defined the whole table also. We've given it some names. We can just go to data and now select select range. So when you click on select range, the box opens, shows whichever ones you have. So when we click on name and click on OK, it selects the name column. Let's go to data again, select range. Now let's select name or class, which is the second one, and click on OK. So you see that the class column or the B column gets selected and you can use it. Let's go to data again, select range, and this time let's select leaf. Just to show how it is used, click on OK and the leaf column or the D column gets selected and we can make use of that. Whatever, however we want to use it in our sheet, in the Calc sheet, we can make use of that. Once again, go to data, select range. This time let's select total. Click on OK and it selects the last column here. If we want to select the entire table, we know that we have defined it as all. So we'll go to select range, click on all and click on OK, and the whole table gets selected. So this way, using define range, you can define a column, row or the whole table, and using select range, you can select that particular name and use it on your Calc sheet. The next option is of sort. Do you know why sort is used? Using the sort option, you can arrange your data in ascending, meaning increasing order, or in descending, meaning decreasing order. You can use sort on the entire data or on a selected part of the data. Let us learn more about sort by viewing this video. With this video, let us learn how to use the sort option. With sort, you can sort either text or numbers. You can apply sort on a selected area of your table, or you can sort the whole table. For instance, right now we are selecting the first column, A column, where the names are. Take a pointer to data, click on sort option. And when you click on sort option, a box opens and it says, do you want to select extended selection or current selection? So we need to select the current selection button. Click on that. Then it shows you a box again opens, says sort by ascending order, descending order. And since we have a name for it, so we select it name and we click on ascending order or descending order. Ascending will make it smaller to a larger number, increasing, and descending will make it in decreasing. Click on OK And you can see the names are sorted alphabetically. So A name is first, then B, C, like that. Alphabetically, the names have been arranged. Let's again select this, go to data, click on sort, and again select current selection. And when the box for sort opens, you can now select descending order for name and click on OK. So you will have the names beginning with Z. So from the last of the alphabets, the names will start from there, and the A name with A, which is Ajay, is coming in the end. Let's see how sort is used on numbers. We have selected the C column, gone to data, select current selection, and from the box that opens, you can either, let's first choose the name, the present is what we are choosing. You can see the options here, case sensitive, range contains column labels, including formats, custom order. You can select any of these. Direction you can change, top to bottom for sorting rows, or left to right for sorting columns. So you can make these changes, you can select these options. You'll learn more about this as you use sort later. So in the sort criteria, we have just selected descending. So the maximum marks will be on top with lowest on the bottom. You can see when we click OK, 31 is the maximum marks and 26 is the least marks. So it gets arranged in descending order. Once again, let's select this C column, and this time click on sort, click on current selection, and let's this time select ascending order. So the least marks will be first and the maximum marks will be in the end. Click on OK, and you will see that the ascending order has been applied to column C. So this way you can use sort for any data or text or your entire table, and you can use various options of sort. Let us now learn about filter. With the use of filter, you can get any information from your sheet. Filters are of three types: auto filter, standard filter, advanced filter. Currently, you will be learning only about auto filter. By using auto filter, you can get information about any one row of your data, or you can get the top 10 list. Let us now know more about using the auto filter. Let us now learn how we can apply auto filter to our sheet. With auto filter, you can get information about a particular person or based on the marks, etc., in any one subject or from the table. So to apply auto filter, we first need to select the column where we are applying the auto filter. So here you can see in the video, we have selected the names column, the column A. And then we take our pointer to the data menu in the menu bar, left click on that, and from the options available, click on filter, or bring your pointer to filter. You see options here, auto filter, standard filter. Click on auto filter, and you will see a button has been applied to the names column. So if you click on the drop down button, you can see you can get top 10 information, or you have all the names and you click on any names, you can get the information about that individual. For instance, now if we want Rahul's information, we click on Rahul and we get all the information that was there in this table for Rahul. Next, we are clicking on Vinay, we get information about Vinay, all the data which is there in this table for Vinay. If we click on the drop down button and click on all, we can see the entire data once again. This was for the names. Let's also see how we apply this on numbers. So select the column C, which is for the present data. Go on data, click there in the menu bar. filter and then data filter. So you see a button gets applied here also. So if you click on the drop down button, you will see that there is option for all data, there is option for top 10, and options for all the marks that appear here, or all the numbers that appear here. So if you click on any one number, you can get data related to that particular number by clicking here. Similarly, if we click on, let's say, 27, we get the data for the row of 27. If we click on the drop down button and click on all, we will again see the entire data. So this way you can use the filter, standard filter effectively, the auto filter effectively, to get data about any text or number from your Calc sheet. The next option is of subtotal. With the help of subtotal, you can do many things. For example, you can get the total of any row and you can get a count of any row. There are many such options which help you apply the subtotal option on your data. Learn more about the usage of the subtotal option with the video. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can make use of subtotals. By using the subtotals option, you can get subtotals, sum, average, and there are many other options available. So first, let's select a column where we want to use the subtotals. We've selected total days. Click on data, left click, and then click on subtotals option. You see the box opens and you can group by. So since you want total days, we have selected total days. Then if you want to make the sum total of all the days together, you can select. There are many use functions. So we select sum, which will give us the total. Click on OK. And once you click on OK, you can see that it gives you the answer 248, which is the total of all the total days. So this way you can get the sum of numbers in this particular column. Let us apply subtotals once again. This time let's use the D column for the leaves, and let's see if we can get either the total number of leaves taken, or let's see if we can get the count of the cells which have been used. So click on data, click on subtotals, and then from this box, group leave is already selected. This time we are selecting count. So we will count the number of cells which are being used here. Click on OK. And you can see it gives you 8 as the answer, because 8 cells have been used. It's counting 1 as the cell where some data was there, and it is giving you a total count of 8 for this particular column. Now let's select the present, the column, which is the C column, and let's try to get the average by using subtotals. So we click on data, we click on subtotals, and from the box we click on average. As soon as we click on average, we click on OK. It will give us the average number of days that the students have been present. So you can see it calculates the average and gives you the answer as 29. So this way you can use subtotals on your data in the Calc sheet to find the sum, to find the average, or use any of the other functions which are available in the subtotals option. learn next about validation. You will use the validation option whenever you want to apply any condition on any of your columns. For example, if you want that in a column of your table, only text should appear and no number should appear, then you will use the validation option. Let us now learn the use of the validation option. With the help of this video, we are now going to learn how we can use the validation option or how we can define validity on certain cells on our sheet. So firstly, when we had used the subtotals option, we had created so many new things here. So you can do an undo one by one so that only the clear data is available to you. So we are just removing all the extra data that we had created while using subtotals. Now we need to select the cell where we have to apply the validity. Then take the pointer to data, click on validity, a box opens. Now this box is going to define the criteria for, if that criteria is followed, then the entry would be allowed. So it can be, the criteria can be for all values, or like right now we have selected whole numbers and we are saying that our data should be greater than, so we have applied a condition here, it should be greater than, and we define the minimum number here. So it should be greater than 100 is what we are saying. It should be a whole number, should be greater than 100. And we can give the input help, we can give any hints here so that the user knows what he has to enter. And in case of an error, you can show an error message by giving a warning, or you can even print an error message which you can type in this box here. So in case the user types something which is not acceptable in the cell, it will show the error message. For instance, here we have given an error message saying greater than 100. Let's click on OK. Now in this cell, a condition has been applied, a validation has been applied. So if we type, let's say 56, it's showing that it is greater than 100, that message is being flashed, the warning is being flashed that it should be greater than 100. But if we click on OK, then it will accept the 56 number. Let's once again, so we select the cell where we want to apply the validity, click on validity option. Now the box opens again, click on criteria because we first have to define the criteria. So here, let's define the criteria as date. So we are saying that in this cell, only the date format will be accepted. And we are giving a condition that the date should be greater than or less than. Now we have said greater than, and we have the condition we have applied is minimum, we have said 7. So the date should be a date format, should be greater than 7. We click on OK. Now if in this cell we type something like 6, it's not a date format, so it says this is an invalid value. If we type 7, again it says invalid value because this is not a date format. So you just click on OK when you get the error message. Try something else. We're trying to type time here. So we are saying 12 hours, 10 minutes. Again, it won't accept it because it's a time and not a date format. So this way, a user, if he is typing some text like we have typed date, again, it won't accept it. In this cell, let's apply the validity or the validation clause. We go to data, we go to validity. Again, we select the criteria. This time, we are selecting it to be a list. So as long as the user is picking something from this list that we are defining, it will accept that input. Otherwise, it won't accept the input and will give you an error message. So we have to type a list here. So let's type a list of the months of the year. So we are typing Jan, Feb, March, April, May, right till December. So in case the user is selecting from one of these or is typing one of these, it will be accepted. Otherwise, it will give an error message. In this case, when we give this list condition, it actually has also puts a drop down button next to the cell. So if we click on the drop down button, the list itself will be shown and you can directly select from that list which is shown from the drop down button. So let's click on OK and see what happens in that cell. So you can see a drop down button has come. And if we type something like 12, now it's giving us a drop down button and we can select one of the values from the drop down button and it will accept that. Otherwise, it will give an error message. So this is how you can apply conditions to the cells. And there are various ways of defining conditions. Let's once again see validity. This time we are selecting to allow any of these we can select. Whole numbers, decimal, date. So this way you can use the validity or the validation option of the data menu. Let us now learn about the text to column option. You will use the text to column option when you have shown text or some numbers of a column with comma or some other symbols and you want that the value of those symbols appear in a different column. With the help of the video, let us see how text to column is used. With this video, we are going to see how we can use the text to column option. In text to column, if you have typed any numbers or text within a cell which is separated by commas or any other symbol, you can get those numbers or text separated and it will come in separate columns. Let us see this by an example. We have typed in the cell AB, comma XY, comma ZA. Now we need to apply the text to column on this particular cell. We apply the text to column option. So we first select this cell, then take our pointer to the menu bar, left click on the data menu, and then select the text to column. So you see a box opens and it shows that the text that we have typed is separated by a tab or a comma or semicolon or space or by any other symbol. So since our separator is a comma, so we will deselect the tab option and select the comma option. You can see even in the preview window, it's already separated AB, XY and ZA into separate cells and separate columns. So click on OK and you will find that on your sheet, these three text words have now come in separate columns. AB, XY, ZA are in separate columns. Let's practice this once more. In the cell, we are typing something different now. We are typing numbers, or let's type the date in the date format. So we are typing 14/07/2016. Now we need to apply our text to column on this and see how these numbers can be separated into different columns. So we first select this. then take our pointer to the data menu. In the menu bar, left click on that and then click on text to column option. You see the box here. Again, now look for the separator, which is a slash this time. In fact, in the box here, we don't find, we can only see tab, comma, semicolon and space. Since we have used the slash, we will have to tick on the other. We will have to deselect tab, and in the other, let's type the slash that we have used. As soon as we type slash, in the preview window, you can see that the numbers get separated into three different columns. Click on OK and you can see this happening on the sheet. So 14 has come in one column, 7 in the next column, and 2016 in the third column. So this way you can use the text to column option. Let us once again use or practice this. In the next cell, we are typing, now we are typing some text. So we have typed computer dot shiksha. So here the separator is a dot. So we want to separate them into two columns by using the text to column option. So first we will select the cell where we have typed computer dot shiksha. Take the pointer to data, left click there, click on the text to column. Now, again, the dot is not appearing in the predefined options for separation. So we deselect tab, select other and put a dot there. And you can see in the preview, computer and shiksha have been separated into two columns. Click on OK and you can see that applied on your sheet. So this is how you will be using the text to column option to separate any text or numbers into separate columns which have been typed on your sheet in any cell. Next, let us learn the use of the formulas for now, today, year, day and month. Do you know why the now formula is used? By using the now formula, you can get the current date and time on your sheet from your computer. With the help of this video, learn the use of the now formula. With this video, we will see how we use the now formula. So the now formula, wherever it is applied, will give you the date and the time. So let's first select the sheet 2 so that we have a plain working sheet where we can apply the now formula. And since we want to apply it in the A column, let's type now as the title in the first row. Now in the next cell, let's type the now formula. It is very simple. We have to type equal to, then N-O-W, now, begin bracket with shift and 9, and close bracket with shift and 0. You don't have to type any numbers, anything. Press enter. You see right now it is not showing the date and time. So we just extend the column because it's a large input that is required. So you can see the date and the current time has been taken from your computer and is shown in this cell. This is how you use the now formula on your sheet. Next, learn about the today formula. You will use the today formula when you want to insert only the date on your sheet from your computer. Let us watch the video and learn the use of the today formula. Let us watch this video and learn the usage of the today formula. With today formula, you can get in any cell on your sheet today's date. So today gives you the date, today's date from your computer. So firstly, let's type in the C column the title today in the first row, because this is where we are trying to apply that formula for today. In the next cell, let's type the formula for today, which is equal to TODAY, today. And then begin bracket with shift and 9 and close bracket with shift and 0. Remember, you don't have to type any numbers, anything within the brackets. Just press enter and you can see that you get today's date in that cell where you wanted, where you applied the today's formula. So this way you can use today formula to get date on your sheet, today's date on your sheet. Let's now learn about using the formulas for day, month and year. You will use the day formula whenever you need to find the day for a particular date. Similarly, you will use the month formula when you need only the month of a particular date. You will use the year formula when you want to get only the year from a particular date. By watching the video, learn more about using the day, month and year formulas. We now learn the use of the month formula to find out the number of the month from any given date on our sheet. So first, wherever we want to use the formula, let's just type the title month. So we are typing a title here, M-O-N-T-H, month. And then in the cell just below that, let's apply the formula. You have to type equal to and then M-O-N-T-H, then begin bracket with shift and 9 key. And then it says number. So you select the number or the date from where you want to find the month. And then close the bracket and then press enter. So from this date, you can see it was the 7th month, July. So it has shown you the answer as 7. So the number of the month is 7. So this way you can apply month. Let us now see the usage of the day formula. You use the day formula to find out which day of the month is in the given date. So from any date, you can find the day formula. Let's first type day as a title. So we are typing day and then just in the cell below, we will type the formula for day, which is equal to and then type DAY, day, and then it shows you when you open bracket, when you type the beginning of the bracket with shift 9, you have to type the number or the date. So we select the date from where we had typed the now formula and close the bracket, then press enter. So from this date, it will find out which day of the month it is. So you can see it says that it's the 14th day of the month. So this way you can use the day formula to find the number of the day in the month or from any date on your sheet. Let us now see how the year formula is used. The year formula will give you the year from any date on your sheet. So first, let's type the word year as a title where we are going to apply the formula, and just below the title in the next cell, let's type the formula for year. As you know, we have to start with equal to and then we need to type YEAR for year, begin bracket with shift and 9, and then it says number. So you have to select the date from which you want to find the year. Select that, close the bracket with shift and 0, and then press enter, and you will find that it gives you the date, the year from the date. So this is how you can use the year formula. Now you can revise the formulas that you learnt in the earlier class. Go ahead and revise the formulas for average and average A. If you face a problem, watch and learn from the video. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of the average and average A formula. With the average formula, you can get the average of any numbers. Whereas with average A, you can get the average of text and numbers. It counts the text as one when we use average A. So first we have typed average as the title where we want to use the average formula. Now let's type some numbers for which we will later find out the average. So we are typing 60 in one cell, and in the next cell in the same row we are typing 70. And then we are typing 80. So let's see what the average would be. As you all know, if we take the average of 60, 70 and 80, the average is 70. But let's see how we get the same answer with the formula. So we first select the cell where we want to use the formula. Then we type the formula equal to AVERAGE average. Begin the bracket with shift 9 and then it says number 1, semicolon number 2, or you can select the numbers that you want to take the average of. So we have selected all the three numbers. Then close the bracket and press enter. So we have taken these three numbers, selected all of them together, close the bracket, and now we press enter, and you can see you get the correct answer of 70. So average is being used for getting average of numbers. Remember this, you will use average formula only where numbers are there. Now let's see how we use average A, where both text and numbers are there. So we first type the title here, average A. Then let's type some text and numbers for which we will find the average. So we are typing in this next row here. We are typing first, let's type some text. So we are typing A. In the next cell, we are typing a number. So we have typed 50. In the next cell, again, let's type a number. Let's take 50 again. And let's also, in the next row, we are typing B as the text. And another number we'll type 100. Now let's see how we apply the average A formula in the first row that we have just made. So wherever you want to get the average A, first select that cell. And after selecting, let's type the formula for average A, which is equal to average A. AVERAGE A. Begin bracket with shift and 9. And then it says value 1, value 2 separated by semicolons, or you can select the values that you want the average A for. And then press, after closing the bracket, we press enter. So you can see it has added 50 and 50, 100, but it has taken the count as 3. So A also has a count of 1. So 100 divided by 3, the answer it's giving you is 33.333. In the next row also, we are doing average A. So equal to average A. And then we have selected both the text and the number. Close the bracket and press enter. So here, it gives you 100 is the only number, so the total is 100, but the count is 2, because the count for B is also taken as 1 in the average A formula. Remember that in the average A formula, you need some number and a text. If there is a text and a number mixed up, then average A formula can be used. However, if all the numbers or all the count, the cells are having only text, then it will give you 0 as the answer. So this way we have just typed A and B in two cells and we are typing equal to average A and then we are selecting both A and B. So although the count is 2, but there is no number. So it shows you when we close the bracket, press enter, it shows you the answer as 0. So you should remember average is for numbers, average A is for text and numbers together. And average A cannot be used only for text. It will give you only 0 as an answer. Next, go ahead and revise the formulas for count A and square root or SQRT. Today's class ends here. So all of you save your file and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned about some of the options of the data menu like define range, select range, sorting, filter, subtotal, validation, and text to column. Then you learned about the formulas for now, today, month, day, and year.
Computer Shiksha is supported by
Thank you.